God damn, what hath we wrought? Degreelesses, baby. That's right, it's time for another episode of Everything is Fucking Retarded with your host, the People's Champion, everyone's favorite stunning and brave culture critic, 21st century digital boy, and the world's last and best hope for peace. Me, Shanghai Pete. Thanks for chilling with us tonight. We've got a bunch of revolting, idiotic, and just plain dumb shit to make fun of today, so let's get right inside it. Oh man, it's been quite an exciting week, hasn't it, everyone? Before we go any further, we do need to mention one actual good thing that occurred. Against all odds, Bethesda removed the de novo anti-cheat system from Doom Eternal in the 1.1 update. Holy shit, I didn't see this coming. Congrats, Bethesda, you've managed to one time meet the absolute minimum standards of your customers by undoing an obviously detested change and returning your game to the basic standard of merely being playable. Is this what constitutes a reason to throw a party these days? That a developer simply refrained from ruining a game? God help us. Meanwhile, the Pokimane versus It's a Gundam drama marches inexorably on. While Gundam continues to serve up his usual high-quality hysterical content, some of which features his ongoing roast of that ignorant, entitled little trollop, she, unsurprisingly, has only been making a bigger fool out of herself, which we love to see. Or preferably not see, as the case may be. Anytime a rich, privileged idiot gets what's coming to them, really gets my rocks off. Boner fucking city champs, that's where I'm living right now. It also looks like It's a Gundam broke 400k subs, thanks in part to Pokimane's unsolicited yet timely assistance. So, congrats to him. We're all rooting for you, dude. Now, in other equally absurd areas of the internet, the garish vomitorium of Keemstar and H3H3 continues to disgust and nauseate people of a reasonable disposition all over the globe. Looks like sponsors are dropping left and right as these two children continue to make a mockery of both their self-respect and their brands while simultaneously calling into question the very concept of an adult. Good. Fuck you guys. I hope your channels disappear and I never have to hear anything about you ever again, as unlikely as I'm sure that probably is. I mean, holy fucking shit, have any of you seen the sheer amount of nonsense this is generating? Hundreds of pages of infantile bickering on Twitter, virtue signaling, torrents of embarrassing videos, hundreds of thousands of likes and comments. I even saw some mentions of alt-right movement. Congrats, with the recent edition of a boxing challenge being issued, this now checks every single box on the list of dumbest shit conceivable. Proof of the failure of the human race right here. Wouldn't it be terrible if this fuckboy civil war had some sort of blowback or collateral damage on normal content creators? Good thing that's never happened. Oh wait. On a lighter note, some of you may be amused to learn that thanks to the research I did on these two clowns for my last video, YouTube has seen fit to start contaminating my up next feed with their laughable excuse for content. Fuck me. I knew I should use a private tab. In a way, I suppose I deserve it. Moving on, the trash fire that used to resemble Twitch's ghastly idea of a trust and safety council is still burning, which I'm sure comes as no surprise. A more paralyzing example of crippling irony I don't think I've ever seen. Sorry to disappoint, but I will definitely not be covering this. If you'd like an exhaustive and probably overly verbose explanation of exactly why, you can scope out my previous video here. Suffice it to say, my policy, at least for now, is to only make a video about a topic if I feel like I have something to say about it that most people either won't or aren't. And in this case, I don't really think I have anything to add to this. People like Jeremy at The Quartering, It's Gundam, Asmongold, and others have this one pretty much covered in my opinion, so I'll leave them to it. It's just so unbearably stupid, it makes you want to eat a window, huh? Anyone remember when things used to actually need to happen in order for there to be news? Events of some type needed to occur? Now all you need to do is wear some antlers or say something retarded or type the wrong word to the wrong person and boom. 24 hours of news cycle are created out of literally nothing. Am I the only one who thinks this is absolute peak insanity? I'm sorry, I just don't think I'll ever understand how what some random person types or says on the internet constitutes news. The president, a celebrity, or someone objectively important whose actions may potentially affect large groups of people? I mean, sure, okay, report on that, but just regular people typing or saying dumb shit on stream? In whose world does this matter? To whom does this matter? You want to send a reporter down to the corner of 8th and Grand outside my crib in LA to write articles about what the crazy people there are saying too? Oh no? What about if they had a blue check mark and they said it on Twitter? Oh, now it's news all of a sudden. Next up, and I hesitate to even give this discussion the courtesy of calling it a debate, but sure, let's go with that. The debate over whether or not games like Sekiro and Dark Souls are too hard is back. That's right, there's a new installment of the long-running series entitled Self-Styled Journalists and Ivory Tower Media Elites Fish for Clicks with Rage Bait Virtue Signaling. Thank God that's back, right? Yes, because as we all know, it's totally possible to please everyone, right? So when a game fails to do that, we obviously need a media uproar about it, right? As regular viewers will no doubt be aware, I refuse to engage with specious, disingenuous arguments like this at face value because that only buys into the narrative that there's any truth or sincerity behind the premise here, and there is not. This is not a real issue, it's a problem made up by fake journalists and desperate morons to farm outrage for clicks, views, likes, and shares, the currency of pathetic failing institutions and out-of-touch media everywhere. 99% of the people who play these games do not think the difficulty curve of a game whose entire identity is predicated on being hard is a problem. That's the audience. Who do you think is buying these games anyway? Exactly, people who are fans of the genre. Who buys a Souls-like game and then goes, oh, boo-hoo, where's the easy mode? Does anyone buy a Mario game and then complain about all the mushrooms and platforming? Fuck out of here. I bought Bloodborne and Sekiro even though I knew there's no chance in hell my meager skill at action games would be up to the task of beating them. Did I whine about it? Of course not. I enjoyed them for what they were and felt a sense of accomplishment at my personal triumphs, however small. I knew what the fuck I was buying, just like everyone else. Of course, their cover for this particular outrage farming operation is to concern troll and be offended on behalf of disabled people, who they theorize may struggle with normal controls. Whatever truth there may or may not be to that, I'm certainly not qualified to comment on the veracity of a statement like that. Anyone with literally any sense at all would, I'm sure, naturally assume disabled people don't need anyone being offended on their behalf. No one does. It's actually more offensive to assume that they do. They're more than capable of speaking up for themselves. This kind of garbage and transparent hypocritical posturing is exactly why everyone hates the establishment media so much. Take your deceitful narrative someplace else. We're not buying it here. Now we also, sadly, need to briefly mention what is quite possibly the most fitting and perfect conclusion to one of the more ridiculous and morbid spectacles of the year. That's right, I'm talking about The Last of Us 2. Sony and Naughty Dog have managed to channel absolute peak 2020 by copyright striking themselves. If for some inexplicable reason you needed more evidence of just how out of control Sony's rapacious criminal enterprise of content langoliers scraping the internet clean of all offending content had gotten, here it fucking is. Nothing else to really say about this. It's hysterical, it's sad, it's horrifying. I can't really think of anything better to represent this foul year of our Lord. Lastly, it looks like that sickening Captain America was selfish article was removed already. I know this technically is comic book stuff and that's typically not my area, but I'm gonna break my own rule. I had to mention this. For those of you who mercifully may be unaware of this, let me ruin that fragile piece for you by briefly summarizing. CBR.com recently published an article positing that Steve Rogers, Captain America, wasn't a hero, he was selfish. Now, let's put aside the obvious idiocy of calling someone selfish for volunteering for military service in a possibly deadly procedure and look at the larger picture here. If this doesn't prove that nothing published by the archaic and damned establishment media is real, and that the people who create these articles don't actually believe anything they write in them, I don't know what the fuck does. The article did its job, it farmed the outrage from all the clicks, views, and retweets, and now they've deleted it. Why? Because it served its purpose. Because they don't actually believe anything written in it, and they didn't want the inevitable backlash to impact their revenue. Because they're cowards. They didn't want to suffer any consequences, and they don't give a shit about any outcomes. Only money. We're all used to this kind of perverse behavior from pathetic, dying legacy media outlets, but rarely do we see such an unfettered example of it. Now, that's bad enough as it is, but when you think about the unmitigated gall and utter shamelessness needed to publish an article calling into question the motives behind volunteering for military service on fucking Memorial Day, Jesus, that's simply a whole other level of atrocity. A level made even more horrific when you consider that it's only because of the heroes who gave their lives for this country that assholes like this can even sit in a safe space writing insincere profiteering garbage like this without repercussions in the first place. And on Memorial Day, of all days, CBR.com decided profit was paramount and published an article mocking those heroes. It's fucking disgusting. To paraphrase South Park, if you don't want to root for the home team, get the fuck out of the stadium. Trust me, you won't be missed. And on that miserable note, I say let's end this travesty here. Yeah, I think that'll be the show for today. I'm more depressed than I usually am after making one of these. Jesus fucking Christ. Here we are, proof of the failure of the human race. Hope y'all had fun, because I think it's safe to say it's just about all over for us. In the meantime, though, I do want to thank you all for spending this little bit of your free time with us. We love you today. We love you all the fucking way, baby. I've never mentioned it before, mostly because I don't really care and I only have like 4 subscribers, but I do have a Twitter account. I almost never use it because Twitter makes me want to take a bath with a toaster, but at some point in the future when I finally decide to end it all, I may start using it. If you want to bear witness to that, I'm at degreelessness_. I'm not promising to tweet or actually use it or anything, just letting you know that it's out there and who knows what the future holds. Sometimes there are surprises. And finally, on a more serious note, I almost never do this, but YouTube is just so mean to poor little me and all my subscribers that I have no choice but to beg, please buy something from all my sponsors using my promo code, sign up for my OnlyFans, and then download some shitty mobile game with predatory microtransactions that everyone knows sucks. And while you're at it, I'll also need you to upvote the video, leave a flattering comment agreeing with everything I say down below, and then ensure that you're subscribed to this stunning and brave channel, because free content ain't free, am I right? Man, that probably will not be as funny if I ever actually get a sponsor, will it? Definitely won't age well. Hope someone bookmarks this to use as a reason to cancel me 5 years from now.